Hello, hello, everybody, and welcome to another WNF for Guilty Gear Strive. A great turnout today. And new addition to the mic, we have Hirsch the God Teo on the mic with me.
What's up, everybody?
Feeling a bit tired, but yeah.
That's live with the Teo and goes. You're up at 8 for work, come home, do the brackets, run it for 2 hours, and then you gotta do commentary.
Yeah, yeah, especially having the job on the side. I know Jake has to wake up really early as well for that. But that being said, we do have a great top eight lined up for you guys if you want to run us through the matches that we got lined up.
Yes, yes, indeed. So, up in winner's side, we got Zakuto versus Breaker Dave. Zakuto has been entering a few of these for quite a while. I mean, going back to Plus R, this is his first top eight on winner's side, too. He's doing really good. PNW player, Breaker Dave. Of course, no need to introduce him. Great Geo, great anime player in general from SoCal. On the other side of winners, we got Cheto, who is a Mexican Leo player. I think he got top 8 in another one as well, but he's always like on the cusp of getting it, so he's been doing pretty solid. Well, and of course, the president himself, Mr. Joe Biden.
Yeah,
once again,
the bill.
Not worrying about the White House issues, coming here to play some Guilty Gear. And whoa, is that for us? Fire five. Okay, yeah.
That's five.
I got trolled.
Yeah, over here on.
I was about to say. I was about to pop off.
it's a bit of a different story. We gotta pump it a little bit more. So if you guys don't mind, there's a lot of codes still left in there. There's 36 codes left on the table. That's quite a bit of money. That's just free. That can go to our players. So if you get a chance to go ahead and hit those codes, hit the side quest on the side of the screen there on the sidebar. Every little bit helps, and thank you for the direct contributions as well. I see Bacon the Eggs in there with their own $5 just straight to us. Thank you, always appreciate it.
For this week, I guess we're starting a new way of doing it where there's a lot more click quests on the side that can add up to a lot. So that's like I did there, I did a claim code plus all the click quests, I got to $1.40. So there's definitely a lot of stuff you can do on that page to add up the Matcherino pot really quickly. And those links are real quick too. You don't have to do much on them.
Yeah, so hopefully we can get that up by the end of the night. I just started clicking right there. You saw a couple things added up at the end. But well, we do have more matches that we didn't get to talk to on the loser's side. We have Lord Joseph Dong, classic top eighter, I guess is the way to say it. Great soul player from Exerd all the way to other games as well, like Grand Blue, a great grand there as well. And then YJK, a great chip. So another two chips in this bracket, Joe Biden and YJK, as well as Calamity and Octo Pimp on the bottom there. That's going to be a mirror in losers on that side.
Duncan team kill.
Yep.
You love to see it.
Definitely.
All right. Yeah. We're getting ready for our first top eight match. Reminder that this top eight is all 3 out of 5. We have Zakuto and Breaker Dave going up next. Just waiting for them to actually go.
Yeah. Did we see Zakuto play Exolancer earlier? Was that the match?
That was Kai versus Geo.
Yeah, so we did see this matchup and how Zakuto played. So Exolancer, a really great Geo from Giovanna. Usually is in top 8 here, but as you see, nowhere to be found. And in their place, we have Zakuto.
Yeah, he did edge that one out 2-1. Breaker Dave, though, kind of like a different beast with this character. He's kind of really good at like switching it up really quick. So we're going to see how Zakuto handles that in the 3-0-5 situation, too. Yep. And they're catching up. 6B Food Arc into the corner already. Gets the counter at instant burst.
Yep, Breaker Dave wants to keep the momentum here. Nice, gets the throw, gonna set up that cross up, gets the close slash, goes for the JS.
Make a challenge with Zakuto, but she's plus there, you gotta be careful what you do. Nice, DP to counter the DP, into the super, we're gonna go wall break too. All the way. That was the setup, safe jump? No, cross up, good block. Breaker Dave is trying to find that last hit, please don't burst.
Oh no, dropped it on the last hit. Zakuto gets a Stun Dipper RC, the classic eye. Now in the corner, baiting, they jump out. Can't get the air throw, does get a GH, so more pressure.
Yeah, super is safe. Nice DP. Alright, bring it back. A. One more confirm, can do it. Nice block.
kept himself safe with the 5D RC. And the spacing forces the burst again out of Breaker Dave. Even if Sakuto loses here, it's still a nice advantage in the next round. And doesn't need it, has the round advantage as well.
What a comeback. Didn't burn his burst either, because stuff from Sakuto. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, real Kai patience there. Immediate burst there, though. Nice 6B.
Into the corner again. Gonna confirm off that? No, he's not. Breaker Dave challenging, but still stuck in the corner, trying to find his way out. Alright, charged on edge, pressure. Sock does a really good job just caging him in that corner, not letting him get out. Keeping the pressure up with the RC.
Nice frame trap there. It does get a big chunk of damage off of Breaker Dave.
Finish! Yeah, that Geo TP is kind of like quick and you don't really see it happening, but definitely gotta be ready for it.
Yeah, here comes the frame traps and the full run-up throw, just like the memes, to fruition, does get the round over Breaker Dave.
Yeah, something I didn't notice earlier in watching Sakuto play against X-Lancer is that he was doing a really good job of just getting those throws in, just like squeezing him where he could, and keeping him like really unpredictable. He's been really very solid with that.
Yeah, and being able to do it at your tip 5S range pretty strong as well.
Alright, 2D dog, not working out. Counter 2D, but nothing off of it. Nice throw. Yo, dash pressure still tricky.
Oh, I don't know if Dave missed the instant air dash there or if that was intentional, but does get a big hit here.
Alright, we get the wall break. What's the Oki situation? Nothing. Maybe hard baiting DP or something.
Oh, run up 2H, catches, and close slash gets a counter hit.
Ooh, 2D dog.
Unfortunate OTG there.
It's anyone's game right now. Because the side swap, I like it. Into the charge stone edge. Nice bait. He's got the meter to RC it though, yep.
Oh, committed to the DP!
Oh, chance? Hey, the end of round overhead, the fighting game classic.
Oh, no. Breaker Dave, unfortunately, couldn't get the full punish on the DP. Let it rock.
SDP gets it. Sakuto playing really, really solid right now. Yep. A nice throw. Hey.
Charge Sun Edge into another tick throw. Putting you in the corner. Now you have to deal with this. Trying to FD out Dave. Getting smothered in the corner. Baits the burst.
Yeah, I was about to say, Breaker Dave was quick bursting that spot a lot. It was good as Sakuto to recognize that. One touch away from going up 2-0. Let's see if Breaker Dave can bring it back.
Nice, let's get the arc to get the kill.
Sakuto up 2-0 right now. Playing super solid too. Waiting for a bit. Lobbies, please. Alright, playing footsies.
Yeah,
nice DP.
Ooh, nice burst into the corner.
I saw Sakuto got caught anyway, though. Not a big punish for it, though. Good trade for Breaker Dave.
Yeah, gonna get the wall break super here. Has major advantage.
Alright, so far, Breaker Dave's okay. Hasn't been that great on the super wall breaks. Off of the safe jump there.
Yeah.
In general, very cautious.
Yeah, playing really reserved right now. Sakuto hasn't shown too many DPs or too many risk on wake up either.
Yeah, very content to just chill out and see what's happening.
But Dave does secure the win off that super. Nice backdash, getting back in with the 5k.
I guess full combo, nice. What's this at? Nothing. Maybe jump a little bit too soon, but nice corner pressure, got the throw. Trying to go through some fancy, a little too fancy, but... Oh, no RC burn! Good one. There you go, that's gonna get it.
Yep, the double high kick. And Breaker Dave with a perfect, staying in the game with 2-1.
A dominant third game there from Breaker Dave. After like almost like complete control from Sakuto the first two games.
Yeah, definitely waking up here, getting more comfortable in this match. Oh, the spiral arrow to get through the stun edge. It is projectile invul.
Nice Breaker Dave getting in there. Good blocks on the over. He's been good on those so far. Hey, run up in your grill and throw him. I like it.
It's literally the run across the world to throw you in. And another one.
Nice Shock State, nice grab PRC.
Yeah, I think Zagato thought that was a jump and got caught jumping and hit by the burst.
Maybe. Alright, very good. They got 50 bar on Oki. What's it gonna do with it? She goes for a safe jump. Oh, BRC mix is a mix up. Nice block on the fuzzy.
Yeah, we in the real cheap stuff.
Another one?
Again. Yup, got hit by the fuzzy this time. Breaker yeah, day.
The positive bonus just like gives you all that meter to be able to do two of those really nasty mix-ups in a row.
Yeah. And he's gonna get that tension pulse again. Oh no! Didn't work out that time. And the super big chunk of damage. Breaker Dave here, just trying to control with 5Ks.
Nice, alright. Sokolo getting something going, trying to make this comeback. No! Dropped it! Breaker Dave got 50 bar, he might just burn it to keep pressure. Nice throw tech.
Yeah,
showing
to
amazing.
Keep...
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, just kept them in the corner by catching the jump out with the arc and does get a nice DP.
And blocks the burst. RC, can he kill? No, he dropped it! Oh, but he got the throw! Nice stuff. Yeah, his throws are on point right now. Zagato set point, trying to get the winner's finals. Trying to stop Regular's momentum right now. He's just running it back.
Y'all thought that meme was a joke, but Kai's be like that. And the 5K. Oh, that's for big counter hit
that's
here for Zagato.
And the Oki. Yep. He's been doing that a lot. It's a good read from Breaker Dave. Look at that, all tied up. He's going to burn it. He does. Just get that corner pressure. Breaker Dave about to get his burst back. He's going to burn it right here. He can't on the wall stick. What's the Oki?
Run up 6P. Doesn't work out, but Zagato maintaining screen pressure here. Oh no. Gets caught.
Breaker Dave's going to need one more mix up to work to get a win. I like it. Just do Wake Up Stun Dipper. Why not? You got the meter.
Yeah, nice spatial awareness. Stayed out of range of the super and able to punish on the floor.
Alright, anyone's game right now. So I got burst on deck. No! He bet it all on the DP. You hate to see it.
Yeah, the close ass. And staying alive, Breaker Dave 2-2, tying it up.
I like the idea of like trying to get that one last wild out hit because you think he has the meter, he's gonna do something with it, but just overextended just a bit too much and got himself killed.
Yeah. The 6P not working out for Zagato here. Forced the burst out already.
That was pressure, safe jump. Good blocks with Zagato, not falling for the throw trap. Okay, that's gonna be a full combo. Yep, super.
Yeah. Oh, this is gonna hurt. Gonna have great positioning here as well. No burst for Zagato, has to just eat this.
Yeah, Breaker goes to safe jump, just raw 5D into the RC. Breaker Dave running it back from 2-0. About to take the set.
Yeah, praying on the fact that Zagato was deciding to just hold block there, really scared. Breaker Dave prayed on it. Back in with Spiral Arrow. Nice backdash though.
Breaker Dave pinning the pressure, nice jump out.
And the punish on the 2D.
Ooh, I like that.
Oh,
combo, is he gonna burst? No, hold it. Oh no, missed up. Give him a chance.
Yeah, that seemed really short.
Yeah. Geo is like kind of like a shorter size, like when she's standing, so maybe that has something to do with her air box too. I might be wrong about that.
And just goes for the empty low. Nice jump out for Breaker Dave. At risk of getting chipped out though.
Go try to get that last touch. Gets it there with the 2K. And we're on the final round. Winner of this goes to winner's finals. Will Breaker Dave complete the run back?
Ooh, good buckle on 2D. Unfortunately, gets hit by the Sepultura. Now we're in the corner.
Hey, nice air throw.
Yo, very guilty gear right there.
Alright, keep him in the corner. Nice IB. Couldn't get anything off it, though. RC, yep, I like it. First.
Yeah, the hold 5D. Breaker Dave deciding to commit to the burst after connecting the first hit.
I do like Breaker Dave giving it like a hit or two, just to like make sure it wasn't being baited.
Yeah, a lot of people like to hard bait on that dust.
Oh, not again! Oh, he parred me the burst. Fortune for Zagato didn't break that one.
Yeah, now Breaker Dave put himself in the corner after that burst. Unfortunate.
He's gotta stop doing that. Oh my god. He's died for every single one of those DPs. Just so desperate for that last hit. Hate to see it.
Yeah, it works out for Breaker Dave. You know, very scary situation there after that burst, but, you know, Zakuto kind of gave it away with that DP, which is weird. We haven't seen a lot of DPs from him, but the few times they do commit to the DP, it just did not work.
And you should have seen that after the first two DPs that weren't working, and then in the third one, like, you just can't be banging at that point.
Yeah, especially when you have that positioning like that. He was doing such a good job of staying in far S range, but just slightly outside of Geo to like 5H range.
Yeah.
And just kind of gave it away there with the DPs. But that being said, we do have Cheto and Joe Biden ready for you guys. It's going to be a great match. Leo versus Chip. Very volatile.
That's the classic thing of Leo can control, or Chip can control a lot, but then, you know, Chip just kind of explodes, and Leo's an exploding kind of character, so.
Yeah, definitely. We'll see how this works out. And the round starts, 6P works out for Cheto.
Getting in there, immediate DP from Cheto. Hey, then combo, but he's just going wild right now. He's showing what kind of game he's trying to play.
My man is
Berserker slashing.
Definitely. That backwards hitbox on the Beta Blade there worked out for Joe Biden perfectly, baiting out the DP with the back dash.
Sending the message early that he's going to do it.
Yeah. But here comes the Leo Alpha Blade.
Blocked by Joe Biden. Fortune for Chip, he does have a few ways of dealing with the wake up DP as a lead grab and normal grab. And if he's facing the Alpha Blade right, that can make himself safe too. So he's got a few things he can do against DP.
Yeah, and does get the JS. Unfortunately, can get the second hit of Rekka to hit. Has to find a new way to find this pixel healthier from Leo.
And full burst. All right, he's got it.
Yeah, spending all the cash.
I was about to say, if he didn't get the kill after spending all that.
And the burst at the end too. Definitely needs to make that round count. No 2D after the 5K, unfortunately too far. Does get a DP for the ender.
The DP on wake up, good stuff. Burst out from Cheto. Nice. Ooh. All right, going in again.
Yeah,
nice block to Joe Biden.
Yeah, nice jump out, avoids the 2S.
And Cheto was really going hard on those DPs early on, but after the first one, they haven't been so successful so far. Joe Biden's caught on to the way he wants to do it real quick. Well, that's big damage. First, all right, I guess not terrible burst. He had meter. Can make something happen.
And run up, Alpha Blade gets a cross up. Not too damaging though. And the 5H from Leo.
Yeah, running Rekka. Yeah, it's Rekka. Even though we're not Rekkas anymore, I'm still calling Rekkas.
Yeah, the German names are way too hard to leave. And going for the up. Cancel on the RC there. Does get a leap throw off that setup.
DP, I like it. How smart, I like the attempt because he was challenging to wake up a lot on those situations. Cheto has a burst on deck, fighting about to get his back.
Oh, they stared at JH. Bad burst from Cheto here.
Dropped it.
Yeah, kind of awkward to confirm those K alphas that hit kind of too high.
Yeah, and the slash record is going to do it for Joe Biden, up 1-0. I do like the way that Cheto's like kind of like going for those commit options a lot, and like letting him know he's gonna do it, but at the same time he's kind of calming down a little bit. There's a certain point where you see things aren't working and you just gotta like adjust for it.
Great throw on the cross up there from Joe Biden. Very scary to do in this version compared to old ones.
All right, 5P, 6P, we take those.
Yeah, lost.
Punish it. My trying to gun the DP out of that.
Oh, I don't know if he expected him to get hit, not the conversion there off the RC.
First, not trying to get hit. Joe Biden doing a really great job just keeping absolute control, even through like the random little hits getting here and there. Nice jump out from the guard point, or guard stance rather. Gonna kill? Not quite. One more touch will do it.
Yeah, unfortunately, the Rekka OTG does find the kill with 5P.
Joe Biden looking real clean right now. Hey, just hide. He's in there.
Yeah.
Cool combo. No, not quite. Ooh. Just go for it.
And the back turn stance, very threatening there with stance H. Oh, Joe Biden gets in though, breaks the stance.
Sarcello trying to keep that momentum he had going, but just so hard to keep chip pinned down.
Yeah, just a bit slow there on the punish for K Alpha.
Hey, RC, yup. Here comes the wall. Oh no! Dropped it.
Yeah, rare drop from Joe Biden there. It does get a leaf throw off the tick grab.
Lock, or that to RC, and gets the trade. Joe Biden up 2-0.
Yeah, that P has not worked out for Cheto here at all.
Yeah, when it's sporadic DP, when the DP users don't really like get you anything, you have to start making it much more sporadic. So that way you just put them in the sense of like, oh, he's not going to DP as much anymore, and then you start busting it out again. But right now, Cheto's just going for like this, like, 1 out of 10, 2 out of 10, like, DP success rate, and going with it.
Yeah, bad burst there as well, kind of panicking right now. He's been doing HDP a lot too, I've noticed.
Yeah. It's more committal, but you get knocked out, so it can't be worth it, but at the same time, it's not working out. You're just like, you're asking to die.
Mm-hmm. And nice. Does get the throw there.
Fine, I'm trying to make this a sweep. 3-0. I don't think Cheto's gone around yet.
Yeah. In danger of being sent to losers here. The 5k stagger pressure coming in. Instant air dash finds nothing. Oh, the committal K Alpha.
That seems like a DP bait.
It definitely is. If you do normal K Alpha, you actually do get hit by the DP on the back end. So carrying the dash momentum carries you further and avoids DP.
Makes sense, alright. Alright, Cheto's breathing right now. Finally got in the corner in back's turn. Just immediate DP out, no respect. Cheto's bursting, trying to keep him in there.
Joe Biden's DPs though have been very successful every time he does do it. Baits up the DP but gets hit by the second lingering hitbox.
Oh no, he got mad lucky. Better win. This is your chance.
Oh.
What?
Wow.
Alright, we take those.
Wow.
We stay alive. We take those.
How? The 2D after getting YRC worked out.
Sometimes with sheer will you can make it happen.
Guts. Joe Biden with a confirm. Can't get the wall stick though.
And those DPs have been very low success rate from this game. Kill a lot more than it's helping.
That could have been a very good burst for Cheto. Unfortunately, lost the corner control from that.
There is what you were talking about, yeah. Unfortunately, Leo with no meter when he's got in the corners. And if he's not on back turn, he's not all that scary because you just have to kill. You have to just commit to the mids. And you really just block him out there like Joe Biden just did.
Mm-hmm. Joe Biden with a nice 3-over Cheto. Yeah, unfortunately, just a matter of Joe Biden playing really skilled around the tools that Leo has. Very aware of what the matchup is capable of turning it into. Did not want to lose out to DPs from Leo at all. Something to be very aware of. Committed to doing leaf throw a lot on wake up early to show Cheto, hey, you probably shouldn't do this, but you know, didn't work out.
Yeah, some players you just can't train, and those when you can't train them, you just keep doing the level one as much as keeps working.
Yeah. Yeah.
So Gusto Joe Biden, he moves on to winners finals. Next up we got, is this Akito?
This is Lord Host of Dong.
Host of Dong, excuse me.
This is
YJK. YJK got top 8 last week too after not getting it since like 2 months. So they've been on the open up.
Definitely. But Lord Host of Dong, usually one of the top two finishes here when he does get to top 8 when we do see him. And oh no, Bandit Bringer just spaced too far out, gets far S, but can't really convert off it. Now YJK has to spend burst to get out.
Same game right now, both of them got about 100 meters. Good blocks from YJK. They have luck to cross with Alpha. One more hit will do it for him. But getting that hit's gonna top and gets it on the second Rekka. Nice stuff. This matchup was like so dangerous for Chip, especially in this game where like souls like explode you off anything.
Yeah, I thought after the last Passion Exert Rev 2 that this was the worst Soul matchup has been for Chip, but I don't know, this one feels very scary.
Yeah. With like all the other way Soul's juiced in this game too.
Yeah, you can't rely on Gamma Blade to beat out Gunflame anymore, you just kind of have to commit to the instant air dash over.
Alright. Nice mix, gets him again.
The 6H getting tapped by the Volcanic Viper.
YGK doing a great job spacing himself from that Brandon Bringer. That's the right answer to do against it, because if you block it, you're in a mix-up again. Nice, gets off the Rekkas again. YGK taking the first game. Straight back into it.
The round starts 6H from Lord Hosted Thong, hoping for that big counter hit. Nice DP through the Fafner.
YGK cue the pressure up, gets a counter hit on the second Rekka, but no follow-up.
Commits to the overhead, spends the RC, not falling for the low.
Basically, yeah, immediate burst. Could have been dangerous if Hoso tried the RC there, but fortunately he didn't.
Ooh, right over the far S with the Bandit Bringer. Unfortunately, not a big counter hit.
Eight, nice air throw. Was set up. Safe jump into the mid. They just got hit. I don't know what he was trying to do.
Yo, all mids.
When the mid mix up works out.
Yeah. Three frames, meaty. And the after frames on the 5K, pretty good as well.
Yeah. Oh, pick up.
Nice punish on the Raid Vortex.
Didn't go for the... Yeah, I think he just messed up his execution. Didn't go for the wall combo there.
Yeah. Yeah, that was a bit interesting. I don't know if he thought he had burst or what he was looking for, but dropped it.
Alright, anyway, got back in the situation already.
No.
Didn't burns the meter on the wire. C.
Yeah, nice for S. Anti-air. Can't get the full confirm, though, but does get a run up far S.
Yeah, Josuke will take that burst. He's fine with that. Going into the last round, no burst on Chip. That's... Yeah, so we'll take that.
Oh, no punish on the 5K. Does get a far S counter hit after the Gamma Blade. Nice Fafner, though. Too far.
Also JH, or JS. The blocks and the counter. Nice.
Yeah, ready with the 3-frame button.
I think he tried to bait that DP, but just didn't quite do it right.
I'm not too sure what move that was, but it got Josuke away from the alpha hitbox. And that might have been far S for Night Rage Vortex, but yeah, it worked out for Hosif Dong.
Yeah, there comes a point where like you see the flame effects and it looks like all looks the same from like a certain angle of the screen.
Mm-hmm. I do get as close as far S mixed up sometimes.
Yeah.
You just gut punches all day.
And Soul did 20% of Chip for hitting the Gamma Blade clone.
There's the Fafner and the immediate DP.
No. I think he jumped in a little too late trying to punish it, but just ended up making it safe.
Yeah, blocking in the air is very, very bad. Nice!
I like the bait attempt from Josuke, but didn't quite get it. That's gonna kill. Yeah, it is.
Hit him with another 6H OTG. Oh, this could be big. Oh no, committed to the K Alpha.
DP. Nice DP back. We're just doing shit. We're doing things right now.
And the run up R S works out for YJK here. Does get a nice pickup into the corner. Gonna break the wall here.
That was the okay. Oh, sorry. I thought it was a super wall break. One more touch will do it. Now he gets it. All tied up on rounds. Great back and forth set so far.
Oh, full run up 6P, this man's a chip player. Nice burst, puts Josuf into the corner.
Big damage off that counter far slash. Ooh, nice throw on the Fafnir.
Yeah, very scary.
4-9 meter for Chip, couldn't get the RC off that Rekka. Oh no, he did.
Yeah, definitely gonna die here.
Hey.
Unfortunate. Lord Hosif Dong taking it. YGK has one more chance to get the round before being sent home.
Losers.
Yes, yeah.
Winner stays home. Or loser stays home.
Technically, they both stay home.
That's both right, actually.
Nice pickup. Gonna break the wall as well.
Start from YGK, nice XP. For the meter, yep. And gets a wall break, that's enough to kill. Nice clap back from that last round.
Oh, the 2H again, the 2S, 2H whiff cancel really spawns the chip. Oh, the trade. Joseph swinging the JF.
A lot of little loose hits for both players. Finally, YGK gets something going against the RC for the wall break.
Yeah, if that kept going, Seoul would just have the health advantage at that point.
Yeah.
Oh, big pickup here for Lord Joseph Dong.
RC, yep. Should be dead. Hey.
Doesn't even need the clean hit DP. Just gonna take it.
Joseph Dong on set point right now, trying to advance on losers. YGK playing pretty solid, but it's hard to keep up with soul damage sometimes. Mm-hmm. Nice. Nice.
Oh, just an in short from getting the meter for the RC on the Rekka. Another great far S. They have been working out so well.
YGK tried to hard bait the burst, but then once he went in, Josuke burst, the good stuff from him. Keeps himself alive. Anyone's game right now. YGK got the meter. Oh, nice conversion. And he gets it. Good stuff.
Wow.
Lord Joseph Dong. He was ready for it.
Yo, the 5k, just a great move all around. When in doubt, it'll confirm your combo for you.
It's all right. It's all right. It's cool. It does its job.
But yeah, so that is going to be our first match in losers. That will be Lord Joseph Dong versus Cheto, who we saw play Joe Biden earlier. And up next, we do have our last match of top eight. A pot mirror.
Yes,
you
yes.
Know him. Octopimp versus DFAX Calamity.
Yeah, Octo, I think this is Octo's first top eight for Strive WNF. Because I know he's been really trying to make it, and he finally ended up getting ones. So it's props to him. Mm-hmm. Calamity has been in a few already, and you know.
Yeah.
Calamity is the kind of player who, you know, he picks the top. He picks what's cheap. And he knows what's cheap in this game.
I mean, true, but he does mess around and just play everyone and kind of picks fun people he think is fun.
Yeah.
Did play Ino and Chip in Exert for a good while, as well as having a pocket soul.
Yeah, pocket a lot of things in Exert.
Yeah, my man's all over the place.
Now we got this pop mirror. Always a quote-unquote fun matchup to watch.
Yeah. Right away, the 5Ps.
It is Octo on the left, Calamity on the
yeah,
right.
Yeah, just for clarification, Octo is my leg and Calamity is Calamity. Calamity is red, Octo is gray.
Yeah. Oh, the punish on the Hammerfall with the Kara Bot Buster. That's knowledge right there.
Definitely.
Nice XP, no combo off it though. Garuda, another one. Oh, I got grabbed.
Oh, die high.
Into the burst safe route, straight into the heat knuckle. Calamity goes up one.
Oh, the Mega Fist coming out, trying to jump away. Trade. Oh my god, just inside of range of 2D.
Alright, here we go. What's the gas?
Oh,
SXP?
No.
Another one. One more? No, goes for the grab. This is it though. Oh, it's Octo turn. Good block. Classic Octo, just went for the 5D, yeah.
He's definitely and returning the favor. Blocked again.
Yo, we got footsies?
Yo.
Yo, put this in the pot, man?
Garuda what
kind of timeline is this?
Oh my goodness.
Yo, let's see some Calamity. Let's go into the Garuda.
Yo, this is straight up a match of the TV.
That's your reward for footsies. You get the Garuda people to death.
Oh, catches the backdash with Garuda.
The back climate playing mega calm right now. Not trying to overcommit.
Yeah. Locking these 2Ds.
Yo, the footsies are out of control right now.
Nice big 5H, unfortunately. Burst. Ready for Calamity. Garuda.
Anyone's game right now, and the 5P mash takes it for Octo. Jeez, that one went down to the wire.
Yeah, guessed Heat Knuckle, guessed wrong.
Alright, like, Octo getting out of the Garuda situation, not trying to hold it anymore if he can't even help it. Good block from Calamity.
5D has zero success rate in this matchup.
Alright, so that works out for Octo, because the 2K2D is in there, Garuda.
Yep,
another one.
Oh.
A Pop Buster. Another one. Hey, gets another throw, and that's gonna kill. Yep.
Bam. Octo with the matchup. The Spacey's matchup. You know, 5D is not intended to hit, it's just to set up the Pop Buster.
It's all a ruse. Octo doing a great job keeping Calamity in the corner right there. Really great use of those far slashes.
Oh, using the armor of Slidehead to beat out Slidehead, unfortunately gets busted.
That's the Pog classic. They both whip grabbing from intro, and the first one on mash against it. Alright, Heat Knuckle in the corner, second kill! No, not quite.
Break.
Sliver left.
Yup, just gonna chip through the armor with the 2D.
Yeah, when Pot's at low enough life that the armor like no longer applies for his armored boost.
Oh, caught him jumping out, couldn't get too much off it. Does get a 5P.
Nice pressure finally burst save. Yeah, that Garuda's hit now, like the hitbox is really good, but also like reels back his hurtbox a lot too.
Yeah, it's a real strong move. Does get their own Pop Buster. Not enough to kill, does have the meter RC. Oh, no.
Another one? Jeez, that did a lot.
The legendary combo Garuda Garuda. High execution character.
I mean, keep him in the corner. It's a counter hit, close slash into the pop up. That's a good grip. G into Garuda. Another one. Give me one more.
Oh, yeah, you're just taking the chip at this point. Unfortunate.
And, like, there's nothing you could do.
Yeah.
You just have to hold that. It's either you get hit or you block.
Yeah.
And it's like, it's a checkmate situation.
Yeah, guard break real strong in this game. Oh no, you're put back into the corner. Your only hope is FDing out.
It's out of the corner, finally. Clam is doing a really good job keeping it in that corner. Hey, counter JH, can't get anything off it. Flick, we take those.
Using PRC to stay in just for this Garuda, the threatening. Showed him 10 Garudas earlier so he can get in with one Carl Pop Buster.
Like, well, I could block this Garuda for the next 5 of them, or I can get Pop Buster for the same amount of life. Alright, Octo's turn, Garuda.
Yeah, speedrunning this. The 5D again! Zero hit rate.
Yeah, I think like at this point in the game's life, like about two or so months in, like you're gonna be being able to pay attention to a lot of those 5Ds.
Yeah.
Especially when you know it's a player who likes doing them.
Yeah. Especially with a character like Pog who has not too many overheads to look for.
Oh, nice backdash throw. Kill the RC to kill. Wasn't ready for it. Hard bait the first and the last one. As I just shamed it from doing so many. Works out for Octo.
The first hit of the 5D.
In my defense, I think that was a quick release 5D, not the old ones. So I'll save a little bit of space.
The 2D footsies are back, getting burst to the full screen, having to eat these glide heads. Nice jump over, getting the knockdown. Octo securing the corner, gets a Pop Buster.
I'm here for a wall break. Just trying to hold it, Garuda.
Potentially might be a better position without the wall break and just hold this Garuda here. And threaten, does have the meter now for anything.
He's doing a pretty solid job of escaping the Garuda setups when he can. He's not been holding him as much as Hawkeye's been holding him. 5D works up, he's like a purple beat. mean Zakuko blocked that, but he just wasn't ready for it.
Oh, I don't know if that was Kara back fist or just wanted to escape.
See you, Octo. If this was, if it was a different game, you would have thrown that, I know.
Oh, Calamity getting caught in the backdash. It's not your exert backdash anymore. A lot more vulnerable now.
Backdash in the old games for Pop was like very vital to how he got out of stuff.
Yeah, only having one vulnerability frame.
Alright, Calamity back in there, keep him in the corner. Nice, keeps him in there. Full combo? No, dropped it. Hey, nice jump up from Octo. Rude. Goes yep. for close slash.
Ooh, got caught in the Mega Fist. No, not a trade. Calamity apparently Mega Fisted a bit earlier. Mega Fist back in. Octo. Gonna sneak in the last 5D. Nice jump out of the Garuda.
Yo, he zoomed in there with the Garuda. I respect it.
The car throws are the biggest buff potential to ask for.
Hammer for Kara. Garuda looks so stupid. Alright, Octo on that point.
Yeah, clashing. Oh no, Popbuster. You're in the corner as well. Mistimed the Garuda.
Octo continuing the pressure. Trying to hard bait the burst there. No bite from Calamity.
Nice Mega Fist over the Garuda. Garuda again. No!
Yeah, Octo was like not committing to anything after those Mega Fists, trying to bait a burst, but finally gets the hit of that last back Mega Fist. Octo will move on.
Oh, how many times have we got to teach you this lesson, old man? Mega Fist again.
Never stop the Mega Fist.
Yeah, very interesting mirror to watch. Completely different than a lot of the other ones. Very, very patient space. Up until that last few seconds where Mega Fist just started flying.
Yeah, the weird thing about Pop Mirror in this game is that in the, all the other ones, like, really, like, the wild, like, the more stupid you are, the better off you are for it. But in Strive, it's a little bit more, like, actual, like, you have to, like, really, like, space yourself out for it. It's very interesting how it works out that way.
Yeah, the biggest change probably would be the fact that Slide Head doesn't knock down if you block it anymore. Before, it was unblockable. So you really had to commit to jumping or backdashing, and those are usually super lengthy to get around the Slide Head.
Yeah, it's that about Slide Head, and also that Slide Head has armor now. So before, if you were in the Pop Mirror, you'd want to be the first one to slide it, get the unblockable knockdown. But now you want to be the second one to do it, so you can get the armor and then go in. So like the dynamics of it really changed.
Yeah. Yeah, and here we are at the Match Reno again. Let's see how we are doing. Don't forget, you guys still have plenty of time to go ahead and get the code. 21 codes remaining. We're at $23.70. Still time to do those quests as well. Just click the link and a quick pop-up will pop up saying thank you for contributing to this event. You just donate money just like that.
Those codes on the tables. That's free money for the players. Matrio's not believing in all y'all to click those codes. Don't let them win.
Lord Joseph Dong versus Cheto here.
So Leo, kind of a... If the Leo knows the matchup, it could be not too bad, but depending on how much you know it, it could be kind of rough. So it's really depending on what Cheto's like knowledge of the matchup is, maybe. Alright, Josie's pressing pretty nicely. Keeping the corner, not overcommitting.
Oh, trades with the Fafnir, that's pretty nice for Josuke.
Media burst. Oh, that worked! Okay, fortunate. Yeah, the later hitboxes of Leo's 5H kind of goes down a little bit, so that caught the Vortex. Very fortunate for him. Wasn't ready for the guard stance. Yeah, you can get a full combo off that. He dropped it, but it got the reset anyway.
Oh, okay, nice stance P. And the JS does get Josuke in, able to convert here. Fading DP, just find it.
Josuke mashing on that DP like he's playing ST.
The 5k wake up option.
Hey, come with the Vortex. His burst? Yeah, he might have died if he didn't burst there. No, yeah, you can't do that against Soul. Vortex goes full screen in an instant. Gets it with a fast RC on the Banner Revolver. Josuke staying in there.
does manage to punish there with the 6S. Couldn't fully convert though. Super far.
Works again. Fafnir works out. Get full combo. He does. Into the conversion. Oh, no!
Oh, I don't know if that was a mistake, but maybe one of Bane Revolver. Got wild throw and spray.
Yeah, I'd be seeing Souls do that. Just like random wild throw input.
The buffer in this game is pretty too generous at some point.
Yeah, it's definitely too generous.
Yeah, especially when you input dashes before your move. Or
six block. And kill. No, if you did a Rekka, it would have gotten enough meter to RC the kill. Still, looking over Chetto, though, goes in with a 2K and gets the round. Yeah, Chetto had like a little bit more like meter awareness when he was about to build that last bit of bar. He could have killed him sooner. You definitely don't want to give Soul a chance.
Oh, okay, the DP. Yeah, that was BDP, pretty sick as well.
Nice mix up, yeah. Going from the mid stance into the low. Hard bait to burst again. Big counter on the Vortex. Couldn't finish the combo, nice XP.
Yeah, sitting with the back turn mix, does get clipped on the low. I don't think it comboed though.
It's the stance S. So that will have gotten the kill. He was confirming with the K's. Alright. So a light wall, just do it.
What?
Just do it. Yeah, first. You're gonna die.
Oh no, the 6P. The stuffed Josuke from the far S there.
Yeah, the 6P is pretty good poke. Has a lot of aimball on it. Or body involved, I should say.
Trading DPs here, but the Fafnir guard break checking. And Josuke still able to get back in with the 4S.
Wall break, yep. Spend the meter, get that advantage. Leo on a slip on a bit of life right there. Lock the DP. Oh, you burst it? The Cali burst? You better make it work.
Oh, big confirm here from Chetto. Does get the. Oh, no.
Yeah, trying to do that against Soul with all the ways he has to mess up pressure on OPs.
Yeah, it's very scary.
See, the pace of that panic burst, starting his burst slowly back right now, but he's taking all this damage. He might not get an opportunity to burst.
Yep, oh, unfortunately stuck in stance. Not able to get fully away from the Tyrant Rave.
Yeah, even when you're dashing back and back turn, those supers will still hit you. A lot of them go a lot farther than you think.
Yeah, their strength is that they're short hops that can cross over the opponent, but that is also the detriment.
And Lord Host of Dawn ties it up, one up. Nice XP. DP's right back as the answer, gets the Fafnir.
Forces the burst out of Josuke here. Josuke answering back with Banyardbringer, gets stuffed by the DP.
Pressure attack from Chetto there, but if you want to really make it work, should have RC'd it. A has a bit punish, yep. A. Yeah, pulse wall break situation, not very good for Leo, so I like them not pressing there. Oh no, you just did it.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. Nice cornering him from Josuke.
Yeah, the positioning was really strong. Josuke might be able to kill with the Tyrant Rave here.
Should be, yeah. Should be dead.
Wow, great confirm. Knew the super in and out to get that punish.
Yeah, that kind of like micro walk that he did is like very good situational awareness that a lot of people just aren't like thinking about. But as I say all this, he's getting mixed into the corner with the super. That's gonna wall break into Oki. See what Chell's got. Berserker Sash? No, fakes into the throw. Nice, smart stuff.
That goes for the cross-up stance. H doesn't find it. Does find a wake of 5k from Josuke that he counters. First counter of the set.
Pop, can you avert? No, drops it. Block where it's facing. Josuke hard bane DPs. Bottom again. It hasn't been working. In the bar. He was more ready for that confirm because we've gone mirrorless combo, but we take those. Okay, looking pretty good. Josuke got him in the corner.
I'm trying to contest with a run up 6p. He doesn't find anything though. Oh,
that risk gauge was max. You better burst, Buchan. Super? No, hold it. I like it for both players.
Joe's K with the what?
I like it.
Yeah, and the burst was shit though. Pretty high up in the air, couldn't really do much with that, but that DP was insane. I'm losing my mind over soul DP.
Hey, when it's good, it's good.
The backwards hitbox on the DP again, right, another one.
Yeah, there's a lot of little things like that that make the matchup hard for Leo if you're not like accounting for him.
Oh.
Nice, fast RC into the full super. Nice, I like it. Doing some piece of burst save too. And Leo could do the thing that Kai does with RTL where you can just confirm it into a super and you get like near wall breaks from like almost mid screen. It's not as good as RTL, but it still could be used as a function.
Oh, catches the Night Raid Vortex with 4S. Setting up the cross up, Oki gets a counter.
That punish? Should be. Yeah, I was about to say, if Soul recovers back quickly, I was about to call. I was about to say something.
You know, call up Dice Gate on your cell phone.
Yeah, I'm like, come on, bro.
Come on.
Like, does he need that too? And that's what Dice Gate says, yes, he does need that too.
Yes. He just hangs up right away. See.
It's not even needing an answer, it's just like his pre-recorded message. He's like, yes, he needs it.
Oh, almost got a little punish here on the withdraw, but JS not as close. Nice throw into the corner, setting up the unblockable or guard break in this game.
6P, just keep me in there. 5K match on wake up, mutual trade, but Chetto will take that. Alright, one keeps wire siege, keep him in there. I like it. And this bait of the throw. Doesn't get the combo off it. Oh, too far! Gets it anyone in the snap. Nice. River Chetto's gonna get the round, but it's Soul and just DPs.
Yep, charging that flash kick, ready for it.
Chetto trying to move on to boost the semis.
Oh
no! Josuke folding right now.
Yeah. Here comes the Leo footsie's committed to the super. Wow.
Yeah, it's kind of super where you just do it and you'll still be at advantage. And he gets it with the JK into the throw with stuff from Chetto. Really controlling the momentum of that last game.
Yeah, real strong there. And projectile super is just really, really strong. Very rare in this game too.
Yeah, but definitely can work out.
Mm-hmm. Is that Leo's 2S that he did there after the super? That little low?
Yeah. Like a little low slash?
Yeah, that little.
Yeah, that's 2S, yeah.
Ankle biter, wow.
Yeah, it's stubby, but it's got a really good hitbox on it. And you can use it to get those wall bounce combos on it.
Yeah, nice. But so, up next, we do have a Zakuto versus Octo Pimp.
Yeah, Chetto will fight the winner of this match. We'll see how it goes for him. Zakuto had a really strong showing in winners against Breaker Day, but couldn't quite close it out. Octo coming off that win against Calamity in the pop gear.
Nice punish on the pop, but the way it forced the burst out of Octo Pimp right away.
Alright, so he's going in. Keep it safe, I like it. Back Mega Fish just to get out of the situation. Very strong for pot. Oh no, bad burst. Not a huge punish though, but still. Hey, hey. Cool combo, because the wall break.
Oh, outside of range of the 2D. Octo Mega Fist back in. The clash, unfortunate, not ready.
Rain to RTO, that's going to hit the wall. Not dead though, but Vormix can do it. He's going to set up and into the low. Octo just not blocking.
Mm-hmm. A really simple, safe jump setup into the JH after a super wall break.
Just catches them, no confirm, just gets in there, Garuda time. Hey, nice throw. Punish, yeah, he got a caught a DP off that too.
And it's gonna get the meter for the wall break here. I don't think it's gonna kill, gonna have one more mix up.
Not for Zakuto, but not gonna be easy for him. and Megafist Chip takes it. Playing a neutral right now, nice XP, no combo off, just go straight into the Hyoki. Off the back, Mega Fist, Media Burst Makoto, into the 5H counter, Media Burst Makoto, back in the corner we go.
Oh, gets the BRC and ready for the anti-air DP.
Ruda.
Yep, real strong option, goes for the 5D again, does Tick throw off the 5D with the Pop Buster.
I'm going kill range right now. He's got the meter to burn on something too. He just goes for the pressure off the Mega Fist. Pressing button, trying to get him to flinch. Run up 2H counter hit. This is what he needs. Zoki. Hey, run up throw. You can make this work.
Yep. Good luck in the arc. Run up 2H. Leading to the stagger pressure here. Baits out the burst, but they punish as well. Not too scary damage. Does catch a 2H counter hit.
Caught it off the back Mega Fist mash from Octo. Zako clutching that one out. Real strong presence of mind that last bit right there. Alright, confirm. Oh no, drop it. Stun Dipper kind of wonky in this game. It's combo off of.
Yeah, it's a bit shorter than it used to. A lot more stubbier. And the 2H stopping Octo from getting in. But almost just
a whiff punish. I love the little walk back, walk forward. Or pop buster.
Yeah, especially with the new pot animation.
Alright, Zogdo gotta make this comeback again like the last round. Let's see if we can pull it out again. It's gonna be tough. Oh. Whip the air grab, got hit on the way down. Alright. Oh, hard beat Mako, I like it.
You have the psychic heat knuckles. Gonna put Kai at full screen though. Has the hammer fall to get back in.
Running his way out. Back in neutral we go. Or mid screen go rather.
Ooh.
Oh no! Ooh, this could be he might be dead. Are you dead? No, almost.
Yeah, technically not a punish, but caught. Sakuto sleeping on it.
Mako just scoots up with the BRC. Only one the Gerudo set up, but we take the win too.
Yeah, turn it up one
more. Alright, both players just trying to get something going. Not really overcommitting to anything. Back Mega Fist on Octo, it's gonna be a really strong option upon the corner. You have to always be aware they're gonna do it.
Yeah, right over the 2P there.
Media Burst, trying to keep him there. When Zagos hasn't kept in that corner, he's been having a lot of success, but as soon as Octo gets out, that's where things start going down for him.
Yeah, backwards Mega Fist is deceptively evasive.
Nice jump out. A little too high to get anything off of it. His guard bar is cranked.
Yeah. Oh, run up to H does catch Octo on the back end.
Got the burst this round. See if he can close out the win. Nice 2k2 to confirm. It's a RTL. That's gonna break the wall.
Yep.
Alright. Opportunity for Zagato. See what he makes happen. Let's go for a safe jump.
That wrist bar timed down a little bit, but unfortunately bad burst gets him killed.
Yeah, panic burst like that is like you just want to win the round so badly, but you just have to like learn to restrain. Alright, guess okay off that. Nice. Get fresh up.
Back Mega Fist again.
Super strong evasive option for Pot. Alright, nice throw. Misses Sunnage, I think, even though it's on the wrong button. Hey, gets counter DP combo? No, drops it.
Yeah, I'm surprised every time Zakuto's in that situation, instead of opting to go for an air throw, which you think most guys would do, he commits to the DP.
And then that conversion he got right there, he had the meter, wasn't ready for the meter to build. And he could have killed off, and now he's getting Octo a chance to run this back. He's down around too. Hey, counter throw.
Yeah, beautiful throw. The blue RC off Garuda gets a 5D.
2K mash just barely gets it for him.
Yeah, the Aubrey out.
Yeah, if you have the meter, even if you don't have the meter, assume you're going to get it on those like 49 meter situations. Just RC anyway. Because otherwise you give players a chance. You don't want to give anybody a chance in this game.
Yeah, definitely. But Akka calling out that whiff arc. The throw now. Zuckto in the corner trying to jump out, get stuff. Zuckto does barely survive.
Do it for Akka. Zuckto has been kind of playing catch up a lot in this set. You can play that happen a few times, but the back mega is too strong. Any low gap, you know they're just turning, they're just mashing that because they know how good it is for them.
Yeah, it's super good, but I can't believe that went over the 2H.
Yeah.
What you would feel would be a hard call out for the Mega Fist, but unfortunate.
Alright, Hawk is going in. I think he messed up his pop buster a little bit. Alright, can the advantage going? There it is. That's how it's supposed to work out. Fortunately dropped it, but hey, we have to throw. It's the Oki. Got a shock state. RC, yup, and he had the time to see the burst, confirm it that was happening, block it, and get in there. Nice throw attack from Octo. Octo playing really solid right now. He's got to close it out though. I like Octo just waiting, not overcommitting nothing.
Oh, unfortunately, yeah, the second hit of the Sun Dipper broke the armor, and Zuckto able to clean up after it.
Good stuff.
No fear. Nice backdash over the slide head, but 5P from Octo cleanly anti-air Zuckto.
I think he might have missed the heat knockoff that 5P because that should work at most ranges. Alright, just getting in there. Trying to get Octo to do something. Burns it on the Stun Dipper RC. Oh, nice call out. Can you get the combo? Yes, he does. He's been dropping those. Alright, good situation from Zuckto right now.
Ooh, the fearless blue RC forward. Trying to get desperately in range. Zuckto, oh no. Meets the armor.
Nice from Octo. His air throws have always been very strong. Hard being the burst right there.
Zuckto spending the meter on the Stun Dipper. Does get the 5D. Octo spends the burst.
Retouch will do it for Zuckto. Tie it up. And again, just one throw from Temkin, you'll get the round. And the end of round, the fighting game classic, hit him with the overhead in the last second. Zuckto tying it up 2-2.
Yeah, unfortunately, Octo was trying to get some flicks in there on the Sun Edges, but they were just like a bit too slow.
Yeah. Alright, good confirm Zuckto, nice burst point from Octo, trying not to get baited. Those Kai combos are a lot of little areas where they can possibly jump and bait it.
Definitely. And there we go, the Stun Dipper again, keeping up the armor. Nice 5P's from Octo, does get the Hammerfall in there.
Playing really aggressive right now, he's really feeling it. Mm-hmm. See if he can get this kill, he does. He is getting in there, I like it.
Yeah, now giving Octo a chance to breathe.
Yeah, Pod and Octo especially are top like, character and player where you give them momentum and then you let them control it, they're gonna really take control. So I like Zuckto just really like enforcing his will, what he wants to do, not giving him a chance to breathe.
Yeah, hey. These arts aren't being contested at all, forces the burst out of Octo.
He's doing a good job of those 2Hs calling out the Mega Fist. Got Octo a lot more cautious about using him now.
Oh my god, the arc actually hitting him out. And yeah. We'll ride the lightning, we'll get the wall break.
Alright, Octo has to make something happen right now. He's about to lose.
No, Octo with the hard baits there.
His frames, no! Try to, I don't know why it's not working sometimes. The 2H to call it the Mega Fist.
Yeah, it's just a timing issue, I think. He gets to a certain height in the Mega Fist, and then the 2H will no longer reach.
Oh, alright, chance.
Let's jump away from the Garuda and the Stun Edge to make sure Octo's watching.
Try to air throw, we'll take the butt instead. Nice. You can make this happen. Oh, and he mashed into the Stun Edge. Zuckto moving on. That was a really strong display there in the last game and a half.
Yeah. Unfortunate. You saw Octo there with the PRC. He saw the jump, tried to get a response heat knuckle in there, but it's just a bit too slow to use a it as an air, anti-air in that way. But yeah,
not the situation you want to use it for in this game so much, but still, like, you know, the Octo's been playing this character for like 8 years or so at this point. So as much as you grind one game, that instinct still kind of like goes to you every now and then.
Yeah, definitely. But yeah, Zakuto will move on. He's going to fight Cheto, who we saw earlier in Loser's Semis. Winner of that will fight the loser of Winner's Finals that we have not seen yet, Breaker Day versus Joe Biden.
That's going to be a good one.
Yeah, definitely. That will be Geo versus Chip. Very fun matchup to watch, especially on the ground, as you see how they play around each other's normals.
Yeah, Breaker Dave, since he started entering Wednesday Night Fights a few weeks ago, he's been like pretty consistent up there, like top three finishes. The 1 week he didn't make it, but the rest of them he's been very consistent getting that top three finish.
Yeah.
So he's really showing his strength in this game. And then Joe Biden, you know, sometimes the chip works out for you, sometimes it doesn't. And this is one of those days where he's the type of player too, even going back to Plus R, where he just keeps the pace going. He's very strong at doing it too, it's gonna be an interesting match to see.
Yeah, definitely a vibe chip, as Pat the Fox
Yes. Definitely not a math chip.
No, strongest of vibes.
Yeah, very, he's vibing out there. Breaker Dave, I think it's a math Giovanni.
Yeah, I wonder if they still exist, have that discourse. Oh, immediate burst from Breaker Day, trying to keep this corner here. Viral arrow and baits out the DP. Can't get a punish though.
It's not the BRC mix up, but it still ends up getting something off it anyway. Oh no.
Yeah.
He's been letting those DPs just go.
Oh, good blocking cross up, but the 5P from Breaker Dave does find the hit and will carry it to the corner. Get the wall break here.
Way too long, yeah. That's the thing about using charge dust as a finisher on the wall. If you're not timed just right, you can definitely flip out of it.
Yeah.
Joe Biden has a chance.
Yeah, with the K Alpha, we'll get the side switch as well. Unfortunately, I don't think he expected Breaker Dave to get hit. He committed to the forward RC and it's side switch.
There were so many good things that almost worked for him there, but just not quite.
Yeah, the 2H, they're really bad on whiff. And the 2D.
Breaker Dave's farting right now, everything working. Friend of the RC up. Should get the kill. Oh, maybe not? No, wall break. Got him out of the win.
But
no
2D...
worries. We match 2D with Geo.
Yeah, 2D is so important in this matchup for Geo. Chips love running in and pressuring with their speed. So getting a really disjointed low like that out there early is so good.
It stores like so much space too. Alright, so the quick first game from Breaker Dave. Giovanni kind of just like fell apart that second round, not being able to capitalize on what happened the first round. Let's see if this next game can kind of wrap tighten up a little bit.
Yeah, let's force the burst out of Giovanni here.
Alright, stagger pressure. Good trade for Gio. Hey, nice throw.
Yeah, the step dash into the throw, real strong. Ooh. Does get the fuzzy setup confirmed with the super. Gonna get the wall break here as well.
Meterless fuzzy setup, that's dirty. The save jump. After burning, yeah, he might die. All right, it's a good start.
Yeah, it does get the corner off that throw as well. It does throw pretty far.
That's out. Oh, he tried. I think he would have lost that trade anyway, but.
Yeah, definitely. Unfortunately, yeah.
Yeah, if he accounted for the arc of that super eco punch as she landed, but he was trying to trigger it out for whatever reason. Alright, he's in there.
Audience air dash, gonna get the wall break with the JD. Joe Biden solid air throw. Oh,
nice.
Joe Biden.
Double mix up off the deck. Mashing DP. He was gonna be so good for just conversion too. He gets so much off without counter hit.
No, we saw him do it again. Spends the PRC there to keep it safe. Backstepping away from Joe Biden.
Yeah, I think Breaker Dave messed up a BRC mix up there, so it ended up working out for him.
5K.
Alright, Joe Biden. Bring it back right now.
Yeah,
Alright. Nice DP. Gang in there again. Oh, corners himself. And bad DP there. Alright, find the burst point.
Yeah, J2K backs down, finds an air hit, doesn't get the pressure spring he wants from it. Oh, crossed up on that JH, another one.
I expect he's getting a lot of little hits here and there. Not adding up too much, but you get the momentum off it.
Yeah, really hoping that Breaker Dave breaks his stick there, blocking these left rights.
Is it gonna hit? No, it doesn't, but she's plus on the way down. Nice.
Oh, yep. Rising J2K is a nice way to get out of throw setups. Gets you back down in time.
Well, alright, Goldberg works out. You can make this work. Nice back dash, and he's gonna get the kill. Good stuff from Joe Biden. So smart right there at the end. It was a really bad situation for him too, because Breaker had burst and like a sizable life lead, and you know, Geo or buttons just kind of like naturally take over certain parts of the screen. He made really a lot of smart little plays right there.
Yeah, it's really important to be able to recognize the how bursting works. If you see that RC whiff, that because it is a hitbox on it, that red ring. If you see it whiff, you know they're bursting.
Yeah. Interesting RC. Just keep himself safe, I guess. A lot of little staggers here and there.
Nice DP through the pressure.
We're gonna far slash work now, yep.
Yep, there we go, another far S into a step dash throw. Baits out the DP again, not working out for Joe Biden at all.
Ooh, I like it, Breaker Dave, just do it.
Yeah.
Full damage, very too. Aware. She got the 100 meter damage buff off that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the farther chip is from doing that record, the more of a gap there is, because he has to reach you with the record.
Alright, keep the pressure up. Fine, just gets out, not trying to deal with that corner pressure at all. Alright, Mr. Mix is working again a little bit here and there. Don't get a lot, but put that tilt on the player and they start making mistakes.
Yeah, caught him jumping out with the far S and created a tick throw setup off of it. Another throw. Good. Oh, fairness. Yeah, went for the blue RC mix-ups. Already RC and saw the burst. I'm just gonna take the win from it.
See if Breaker Dave closes it out here. Kind of unfortunate thing about this matchup is that it's like both these characters are just so good at carrying momentum, but Zio just gets like way more damage off of the momentum she carries.
Yeah, and not only that, she does have the defense modifier as well, so she doesn't bleed as much when Chip does get his turn.
Yeah.
Especially if she has meter.
Alright, pressing.
Yeah, good challenge after the record series ends, and a punish on the DP. Ooh,
full
I like
conversion. Not quite for the 5k, but looking pretty good, good block.
Yep.
The 2D dog.
Yeah, the stagger on that's really strong, especially on a big counter hit. Nice 2P check. Oh.
The burst, yeah, puts him in the corner too. That's big. Yeah, well, I was going to say I'll burst off Joe Biden there.
Nice, gets a cross up. JH, unfortunately, can't get too much off of it.
Pressure.
Yeah, creating. Oh, beautiful backdash there from Breaker Dave. To get the charge 5D combo, will get the wall stick.
And he gets the win. Good stuff to Breaker Dave. Just so good at just carrying momentum.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, really cleaned it up after that first game we saw. And just really.
Joe Biden just like really trying, but like. The way Chip holds momentum in this game is you have to like do 1,000 paper cuts here and there just to try to get the win, but then Geo, you know, kind of just hits you and it makes up all the damage you lost.
Yeah, and reversal super, especially when Breaker Dave did it versus Brekka, just so strong because it gets a big wall break and it does so much damage. Pretty decent at corner carrying as well. And you saw Breaker Dave going for the up RC into the instant air dash combos, and those just carry so far.
Breaker Dave doing really like all the all the good Geo stuff that you would want to do with that character. Yeah. He's really good with her.
Keeping it as optimal as you can, especially the fuzzy mixes, which were just so good.
And before we move on to the Loser Semis, we got a quick trailer for you guys.
Yeah, yep, yes, sir. We're going to play a quick trailer, guys, and then we'll come back, and I'll talk about a little bit more, and then we'll get into some more Guilty Gear actions. Hold on for a second for the trailer.
Dope, dope.
Richie knows. We connect gamers. Welcome to our sitemap. You can tap and discover anything gaming. Find gamers in your area. Find deals from local gaming businesses. Want to play? We'll help you find your people. Create a play. Host. And get ready to play. Search by player or by game. Find your community. Search events, from cultural competitions and tournaments, educational to esports. Visit Vent. Find Richie's in the know. And you can win free food daily. Vent, our virtual mental health spa for gamers. Tournaments will stage citywide and city versus city tournaments in some of gaming's biggest titles. Richie Knows site has easy navigation, easy to find messages, access to tournaments, personal settings, and Richie Roulette, where you can earn daily prizes, plus Vent. On our pull-down menu, you'll find Richie Coins, our reward for engagement system that pays off quickly. And for brands, it pays off even more. CPMs based on engagement just works. Our users are engaged. Tap on a brand's logo, and a Richie coin appears with a set value. Tap on the logo and get the coins. Get the coins and earn free food. We work hand in hand to deliver both a customer reward and your value proposition. It's as easy as tap and earn. Richie Knows is the local social network that's going to be everywhere. Alpha testing in Los Angeles, but scaling to 30 major markets in the US. Quite simply, Richie Knows is everything gaming. Richie Knows. We connect gamers.
Cool, guys. Thank you so much for watching the trailer real quick. It's a little project we've been working with, Level Up with Richie Knows. And they're hosting tournaments, but like, they've decided to just focus on the ones that like we know how to run, which is the fighting game stuff, which is Street Fighter. There's a Street Fighter 5 tournament coming up on... this Friday, on August 20th. So if you guys play Street Fighter V's online tournament, it's open to the West Coast states. Top three finalists will receive over $200 worth of Amazon gift cards. And if you enter the tournament, but you have to participate, no DQs, you gotta play, you'll just get $10 Amazon gift cards just by participating. So, it's a really cool incentive. They want people to like, you know, to know about the site, like the potential it has. For me personally, I'm kind of tired of opening up 20 damn pages to find out what's going on in my local scene. So I'm an organizer, and that's what I have to do. It's my day to day, right? I would rather work with like an app like Yelp, right, where you can have all food in one area. Well, I'll open one app. This other app is all gaming related stuff, and it's not just limited to events. It could be like favorite food spots that gamers like to go at, conventions, you know, and trade shows, if you guys are throwing a local gathering, even like your online tournaments that you're throwing randomly, right? It's everything gets buried in social media. It's really hard to deal with versus like this, like kind of a geo map app tool that you can use to pinpoint your local region, and it's starting in LA. So the alpha test ends in a couple days, but like as you see at the trailer, they want to open it up to more cities and clean it up right now. And right now it only looks good on the mobile app. There's a lot of stuff that they're working on that they want to make really, really cool. And the feedback that we've gotten so far has been pretty impressive. So Hopefully this works out, and you know, free Street Fighter V tournament in a couple of days. All right, back to Guilty Gear.
Nope. All right, for sure. All right, that means
we got what, losers semis?
Losers semis. Cheto and Zakuto will fight Joe Biden.
Yes, yes.
And then that will be losers finals for you.
I think it's the farthest we've had for both Leo and Kai. I wasn't that fights.
Yeah. Kai's been pretty rare. I think he's topped out at top eight, around eighth place, I believe.
Nine, eight,
or seven. Yeah.
I think Kizzy entered one. He got like somewhat far, but he said he didn't quite get top eight.
Yeah. Kizzy was eliminated short of top eight.
Yeah. And just, you know, good Kai play in general. Like, bringing up Kizzy, like, he's like the one that you're gonna watch for Kai, so it's good to see like someone else ripping this character and actually doing pretty well for themselves.
Yeah, there's a couple other people popping up as well. I know Mysterious Stranger just booked a spot in the Bamboo Battles, the qualifiers for that, so one more Kai to take note of.
Bring it right into it. Yep, Leo versus Kai. Historically, not a great match for Leo. It's not too terrible for him in this game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the smaller screen size probably helps a lot.
Yeah. Zakuto playing very patiently right now. Not trying to overcommit.
Pushed into the corner by that 6B and gets a nice tick throw back to stand turn pressure. Wow. Not ready for that clash.
He's being in there, not carrying, nice. Fast RC to get the stance, could block the Zakuto. Eight. Saw it wasn't real. Nice, hard bait on the burst, and this man got the kill. And being able to cancel all stats like that is very good for burst baiting for Leo.
Yeah, it's a real strong option. Not too many people have. Really hard to bait burst in this game on normal without the New York team.
There's all at the punish, yep. No, very strong in his first game. His OTG over the overhead. Oh, that's 30.
That's so smart. Yeah, one of the things people forget, Leo has a command grab that looks exactly like his cross up. Very good.
It's kind of cheap. Big first game for Cheto.
Yeah, approaching with the 5k. Gets stuffed though. Lucky staying outside of range. Just as they say that gets hit by far S. Contesting with 2p. Oh. The meme will not die.
Alright, nice. Doing very good staggering pressure and gets the overhead firm into the wall break and the grip of damage and you're dead. Holy moly.
No steel damage, nothing to scoff at. Ooh.
Firm, doesn't get in the stance though, hits off front, nice DP. He's obviously going off this. Alright.
Leo with a taste of his own medicine, hit with the back end of that. The pressure has metered an RC on the stun dipper. Nice, gets out of the corner.
Right back at him, gets confirmed, no, dropped it. But, it's a throw, no problem, off of DP. Zaro's getting run over right now. That one hit a reverse. Yeah, he's just matching him. He just wants it to come out. His first DP got thrown. His second DP, the input missed. The third DP with Angel on that fourth one to come out.
Yeah, it's one of those situations where you want to die with the thing you tried and not something you're not trying to do.
Like, he just wants the thing to come out.
Yeah, even if it doesn't work. Hope you can shake that off. 2-0 for Cheto.
Yeah, doing something like that, signs of tilt. Let's see if Zakuto can just recenter himself here. Leo's not the kind of character you want to be building against.
Ooh, the SDP actually catching. Big range on it. Nice backdash avoids the stance age. Thun Dipper, though.
Proceed. Oh, big hit. Media burst. Zakuto getting back in there. Not trying to give him any room to breathe. Gets his wide in there. Burst. Alright, he knows the game right now. Chito is not doing any cancels off the JD that he's doing, so that it's punishable on the way down on hit or block. So if he's not canceling, that's a free like grab or something for Zakuto. He has to recognize that if he's gonna do it.
Yeah.
Man, Chito on his way to a 3-0. Jeez, this is real quick right now.
Get to the end of the classic charge. Stun Edge gets thrown though. He's not even scared at all.
He knows he has complete control right now.
Yeah. 5P mash coming out, saving. I was like, throw from the cross up pressure, but just as I say that, 6P clashing with what Vapor Flash. Second time it happened this game. This time it's a different level.
One more touch will do it. And the 6P gets it. That was such a. That clash was such like an exclamation point on like how that set was going for him.
Yeah, 6P in this game, quite a different story for Leo.
Did he just win with a freaking chest pump?
Yeah, dude. Yeah. He gives
bro,
you all chest
dude, that is.
Yeah, he puts chest on it.
That's styles, bro.
Say it with your chest. Say it with your chest.
Put his soul into that.
It created another chest. Bam. Astro project.
Yeah, it's nice for Leo players to have an actual 6P again. It's in Ref 2, it was like more like an armor move that didn't have like a ton of application to it.
Yeah, very rare that you would ever see that 6P used, but in this game it seems to be one of the more definitive 6Ps, really cleanly beating out a lot of scary things.
Yeah, 6P is a very like crucial poke for him, because like not a lot of his things are like high priority like that. Even just the anti-air is very good too, so it's very, very good for Leo in this game.
Yeah. Did so well. That was a is that fifth place finish?
Fourth. Yeah, pretty up there for him. Highest place in Kai finish you've had here too. Coming back next week stronger. He's always entering.
A badge you can wear. Mm-hmm. Put it on your R code.
After you let it load for 15 minutes.
Yo, that'd be cool if they implement like major badges. Like, Evo,
I feel like they wanted to do that, but just haven't committed to it. Nah, we're gonna lose this final set. Got Joe Biden who put Chito in the losers, the free top game winners match. Pretty convincing match too. Let's see if Chito's learning anything from that. And that said, the flash keys were really killing Chito. Like, there was not high success rate. And Joe Biden had no problem controlling the pace as he's doing right now. So let's see if anything changes between now and then.
Yeah, the blue RC, he's not scared at all. Just went in there, made sure he had advantage.
Alright, nice. 2K is round start.
Yeah, 2K does really well against Chip, to be honest, in this matchup.
2K in general is a pretty good poke for him.
Oh, DP, unfortunately blocking in the air, ends up being safe.
Hey, solid the IED. Oh, hard bait the burst? Alright, we got it though. Oh, the Cali burst? Alright.
Joe Biden trading there, getting the K Alpha. Bait that up, bro.
You know what? He got the burst back. That's a successful Cali burst, in my book. And the dust? Is he gonna win off this? Oh boy. Get the knockdown for sure. What's the mix? What's that gonna happen?
Oh, just run out bait or tech the throw.
Yeah, Joe Biden's hard bait, the flash kick, and the random 2B works out. Rare footage of Caliburst almost working out.
Oh, puts himself in the corner, gets out with the K Alpha.
Nice escape from Chito, not trying to hold it at all.
Another one working out. Again, Joe Biden about to. No, based off the bird.
Media burst on his side too. He's got a sizable life here. That can all go away pretty quickly for Chip. He's just moving out here.
He's straight up doing laps.
Shades of ET coming out from Joe Biden. Not trying to interact at all.
Oh, this is the 2S Alpha Blade. Avoids the burst with that.
Killed hard being a DP. Doing 5, but got a hit instead. DP that time. Game right now, gets a counter hit.
Yeah, using that hit to set up a tick throw, unfortunately.
Yeah, he was just matching that 6Ps on the way down. He knew it was gonna come down eventually into it.
Yeah, JD, not as good of a button as it used to be, does run into the CP. Duel 1.
Let's rock. Oh, alright, we take those hits. A little bit funky. Charlie on the corner, and Goli gets out. Counter 2D, immediate burst, trying to keep him there.
Silent Boom, getting some pressure in for Cheto. Advantage, nice 2D.
We'll confirm, get the wall break. He does.
Joe Biden getting back in with a run up 5k.
Yeah, I think with a character like Chip, if you got the positive bonus, you just really make the use of it. Just go in there and start pressing buttons to get to build it up constantly. Chip's really good at doing that too.
Yeah.
Come on, try to go for the 5D, it didn't work out. He did burst on his part too. I don't think he needed to do that, but safety of mind works out. Catch up, burst out, yep. Might have gone wall break off that.
Yeah, getting clipped by the JD.
That was 6 P's off of the well, Chip coming down, they're really solid. It's kind of triggered the properly timed that because of the JDK time, but he's been solid on it so far.
Great confirm off that from Joe Biden. We'll get that tension pulse again. Nice 6P, beats up the 6F. Oh no, drop the combo.
Oh, and I like this. Give the old chance. Oh, shielded. Oh no, super. Oh yeah, he had a lot less burst than I thought.
Yeah, most that damage for as long as you can.
Yeah, I thought Biden was gonna build burst like 3 hits earlier. Oh no.
Oh, bad burst. Does it get punished? The 5P though keeps it tight for Cheto, will be able to get a punish here.
Well, he had the meter, he could have done a lot of damage there, he wasn't ready for it.
Yeah. Nice punish on the witch though.
Are we dead? No, I dropped the super! Oh, he gave him a chance. We tough for Chip, but... No, it wasn't blocking off the YRC. Yeah, you can't press buttons out the YRC. That's what that purple beat is for. Means you could have blocked, but you chose not to. There is a little bit of an RPS situation that happens after the YRC, but in that situation, when you're down that much life, you just gotta hold it.
Yeah. Cheto taking it over Joe Biden so far. Really interesting turn of events. Winning Joe Biden to win the end of the season.
Yeah. And really shows down Cheto is like not playing as like Wild Alley's was in that first set, too. He's like not doing all these like random TPs that were getting killed earlier.
Oh,
J2K. Hey, oh, dropped it. Submit, she jumps out. Nice. Counter DP. Fine, looking alright so far.
Yeah, chasing him down with 2S. It's confirmed.
Nice. Oh, one more touch will do it. And that's going to get the left.
Yeah, rare instance to see a Chip do the 5D combo.
I think he thought the wall break would try to do like any normal combo, so that was like kind of a bit of compensation for it.
Oh no, try to capitalize off that JH, get a combo, couldn't. We'll be able to get a nice wall run here. Ooh, going for a burst save version, I think, but. Cheto saving it for a bit later, does get leap thrown.
Out. Oh, whip! Oh, Wiko died.
Yeah. Committed to the double jump, didn't fall with the button, could have killed him for that leap throw. Big hit though for Cheto here. Nice cross up H.
Hey.
That's a super.
You got meter too. This could get him around. I think he's white? Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, if you do the Berserker slash with the run momentum, you can hit it, make it hit meaty. You just gotta hold it really.
Full combo off the TV.
Yeah, trying to close it out. Just 3-0.
Wow.
His revenge. Looking good on that right now. So another one. Looks like the time. He's going to do it again. No, fakes this time. Stays in front. Gets a throw. Alright. DPs. Yeah. Chance. It's going to be really tough for Biden.
Here.
Yeah. Immediate burst? Oh, he saw it? No, he dropped it!
Oh, does get a big combo here though. This is huge. 2-8 starter.
Exactly what he needed.
Yeah, one of the few meterless ways to get a wall run combo, but Blue RC straight into a Sonic Boom.
Ah, that sucks, man.
No, back to the White House.
Yeah, Leo's pulse wall break options aren't that great, but if he's got the meter, he's gonna do that Boom RC. Because that'll at least get him like control of like the mid range right there, which is normally his real weak point after that situation. Very smart for Chetlo there.
Yeah, especially with someone playing really aggressive like Joe Biden, who blew RC twice after post wall break, to get a really in your face really quickly. But that Sonic Boom, perfectly spaced, perfectly timed.
Yeah, the life lead he had and how little Joe Biden had, really no reason not to do it either. Even if he just blocks it, you got him a little more chipped out.
Yeah. Yeah, or you force him into the air where you can challenge with your 6B that you he was really good at using in that matchup. A lot of people choke versus J2K. They kind of just panic, get tilted maybe. But Chetlo very composed, took the double Jeopardy challenge and, you know, stayed alive.
Yeah, Leo 6B is just really good counter poke in general, though. Pacharino's at, we got 39-70. Nice. Y'all doing some work out there.
Thank you, thank you. We still have 8 codes remaining if you want to put in a couple more dollars in.
That's 8 codes, what, like 3 or 4 bucks in there? Just toss them in there real quick, get them maxed out, do those click quests right on the side.
You know,
took me about
this isn't coming from
2 minutes to do it all.
But I did hear if you switch accounts on Match Arena, you might be able to use the codes when you switch accounts, but I didn't say that.
A little double dipping, maybe a little triple dipping.
Triple dipping, do the quest on 3 accounts. That's real, real big brain.
That's dedication right there.
Yeah, true homie, get VIP status.
Hand the ground pounds, we go. Breaker Day versus Chetlo. Chetlo rolling a really strong losers run right now. Start with top 8 in losers.
Yeah, Breaker Day on the winner's side. Just need a clean 3-0.
Alright, so strong start from Chetlo. Nice jump out from Breaker Dave, not far for the grab.
Yeah, that falling JS real strong at beating out with throws like that when you jump out.
Nice counter throw. Yeah, this is going to be a matchup where it's going to be really interesting to see who takes the momentum there, because both of them have been game through this top 8 just by carrying the momentum in their matchups. Right now it looks like Chetlo's the one with the momentum advantage so far.
Oh, real far, yes.
Nice block. Alright, mixing in there. Keep doing it, if not gonna block it.
Oh, Breaker Day trying to challenge with a 5-H, too far. Nice! I like his positioning from Chetlo, able to capitalize, gets a full counter hit.
Hey, baits it, nice. Can you get the kill? He does. Quick first game right there. Smart stuff on the burst bait.
Chetlo gamer.
Quick first game.
Jeez. Yeah, I didn't even realize that was both rounds. Wow.
That was both rounds. And he was like complete control of both of them too. It wasn't like he got some random run back. He was in charge.
Leo with a nice deep jump carry.
Alright, into the corner we go. Nice matchup from Breaker Dave. Not trying to stay there. Oh, he barely whipped. Got the ready.
Oh, the air dash over JK gets the cross up.
Lock RC, nice. One more touch will do it for Chetlo. There it is, yeah. Yeah, Geo's spiral arrow is good for going through projectiles, but if you do it too early, then it's just not gonna work out. You get hit like that. Big damage from Breaker Day, that's already 60% down.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Gets a throw there. Nice PRC. Caps him safe. Breaker Day blocking the DT.
First out. I don't know about that burst. Let's see if he can make it work, though. He has been pretty strong in momentum so far. So if he can get Breaker Day's burst, I think it'd be worth it. Hey, nice command throw. It's only the second time he's done that this whole top 8.
Oh. Able to survive against the super there.
Oh, that was a game, too. Predator just been first. That's two quick ones for Chetro.
Wow, might be the quickest reset possible. Yeah, very scary situation there versus the Super, but able to PRC it. Are you still... Are you able to counter Supers?
Supers, yeah.
Yeah.
It's just, you can't counter Burst anymore. Yeah. But everything else is like normal.
Got 5k 5h bring so threatening, a big disjoint on the 5h. It's a very scary challenge and avoids it with a back dash.
Big damage. You might be dead. Or you're definitely dead. And just a 5p I will check just to let him know. Now he knows he's gonna kill.
Keep it tight.
Yeah, it's still touching.
As catching Tito here. Challenging after Spiral Arrow.
They're staying in there, not letting Tito breathe. Alright. Finally gets a chance. What's he got? Just goes low again.
Drops it. Let's break for Dave out. Unfortunately, threw outside of the corner.
Let's see a break them a kill. No, not quite. I was trying to get the corner carry. I guess throw RC? No. Another one. Just do it.
Yeah, it said punish, so I think Tetto was trying to mash out there.
Trying to DP, I think. Yeah, as I said at the start of the set, both these players really went with them heavy. Those first two games was all Tetto, and this last game was all Breaker Dave. So if Tetto can get that momentum on his side again, he can definitely reset. But if let's Breaker Dave have it.
Yeah, might miss out on the chance of on the reset here.
Duel one. Let's rock.
Coach, you just spin it. Like, run into my spins, please. Alright, break the gang in there. Bane DP is just matching 2D for troubles. Gold burst, we take those.
Oh, the JP staircase, the classic.
Oh. The JP staircase in this game too is stronger than normal because it builds like a ton of risk. You don't notice it. It's like half your risk gauge built in that.
Yeah, not to mention the IB just does not help you at all anymore. It doesn't let you throw, especially with throw being slow.
Yeah, so you really like just have to hold it. Breaker Dave just tossing him to death. He's got like four straight throws right there.
Nice challenge with the 5P.
Staying in there, trying to be something. Nice.
Spacing out for that 2D.
Good challenge, bro, from Chetto. You saw him trying to go in there. That's a fun part of Geo's game plan that like you kind of just recognize when he's like running real quick and get the throw. Yo, they are moving right now. Got him. Oh, drop it. Okay, what's game right now? Both got 50 bar. Great, they're trying to play a little safe right now.
Oh, coming into the air throw.
Nice, I like it. Just on stance, get it. That's gonna do it.
Chetto's staying alive.
And tying up rounds. This reset point for Chetto too.
Yeah, what's that poster to it? Nice throw. Stagger pressure from Geo, so scary in the corner. Nice up a tour out, not able to fully convert to the burst.
It's gonna hit. I don't know if it was fully hit though. Yeah.
Not too much reward off that punish.
Stuck with Chanto. No, I messed up. Cancel just a little too early, didn't get the hit. Right, one more hit from Breaker Dave will do it. One more solid hit.
Attack. Oh, and a. Hey, we started up
with
Chetto here.
Yeah, kill, he might. No, not quite. One more touch will do it. And the 5P non combo mash. Those 5P did not combo. He just was not blocking.
Yeah, he might have been. That was a counter hit on the last one there.
He might have been trying to mash DP or super or something. But yeah, Breaker was just not blocking there. And Chetto resets the bracket 3-1. Good stuff to him.
Yeah, Cheto playing out of his mind. There are a couple of defensive throws he got really saved him. Especially in that last game, he had one that got him out of the corner there. Really integral.
Yeah, just really just being on the lookout more and more. That's just such a good, important part of like Geo's game plan too, because he just like moves so fast on the ground that you just gets in there, all of a sudden she throws you.
Yeah,
and so you just have to be ready for it. Yeah,
especially with the plus frames off her close slash and the step dash after, not to mention the big disjoints on her buttons that kind of keep you out. Very, very scary to challenge. Let's rock.
Oh, counter 2D, too far to get the combo, misses micro dash too. Goldberg, you got 100 bar and that extra damage buff. Okay, throw into the corner, mix, safe jump into another one. Next throw attack. The first? Yeah, he does. He will probably almost win there from that. Spiral of RC, no!
Yeah, miss space, now eating the DP. Like the hold the Sonic Boom cross up. Oh, wow!
If you got 50 bars, it's a really, really strong mix up. This is like the old exit mix up. With a better back turn.
Does catch. That could be enough to kill there, but has nice positioning here. No, not too close to the corner.
Yeah, look, he needs a sliver of chip.
Oh!
Caught him doing something. That was nice reaction to Breaker Day.
I just feel like it was script guard at that point.
He got a counter hit, so he pressed something.
Oh.
Yeah. Alright, then there, gets the cancel into the super, has to be a grip of damage, cancel him. Mix in the front. Oh, tricky. Oh, I think burst it. Yeah. Two burst from Cheto.
Yeah, that is now a nice change in this game that you can't go through burst with supers anymore.
Does like RTL or something not do that anymore? Is it just guaranteed to work?
I don't think so, but from what I've seen, most supers get out. Zante can't do it, Bonky can't do it.
The super he goes.
I'm sure there's a spacing thing that you can do, but
yeah, probably. Another one. One more gets the overhead, and that's going to be the game. Cheto carrying this momentum so far. Once he gets going, it's really hard to stop him. He's doing a really, really great job of just mixing up all his offensive options.
Yeah, and Leo's just so good at that, especially with the new added command grab, too, something to be scared of as well.
Yeah, he's only busted out that command grab like twice this whole top 8, but they've hit both times. And it's definitely the kind of thing where like you want to like, it's hella good, but you want to sparsely do it.
Yeah. Hey, Breaker Dave in the corner is just so strong. Oh, letting Leo out. Nice throw to interrupt though.
Hang in there, try to throw a thing. It was a little too far for it.
Yeah. Whoa, cleanly backdash the far as.
Just run up, close slash works out for him, getting all this damage. No wall break, but picks up and blocks for Breaker Dave. That was tricky.
Oh, that 2K just so far, but the wake up super.
Yeah, 100 meters, no reason not to do it on Breaker Dave's side.
Oh, full control.
Yeah, when you got invincible super and you got 100 bar, just do it. If you're in a bad situation, just get yourself out of it.
Run up for it.
Oh, yep, nice.
Okay.
I think he tried to bait it. Yeah.
The throw coming up for Cheto again. Put Dave in the corner. Full combo here. Get a super knockdown on this.
His post wall break super knockdowns have been pretty good.
Yeah, he's been mixing up that 5K lift and or with the cross up.
Yeah, just like there, he went low instead. Very good job on those. Dave's gonna throw another one. Safe jump. Kenka calls it out. Chendo counter bar. He's definitely gonna start chugging those moves. Okay.
Whoa.
It's alright.
Definitely feel that was YRC when he got YRC.
I will take that. A dub to dub, no.
Yep. JD finally canceling, gets thrown out though.
Nice throw tech. Yeah, Shadow's playing really aware right now.
Nice, get the cross up there. The overhead full combo? No, Bird.
RC keeps something long way for him. I like the double A on the throw, but a little too high on the Yomi. Got super tripped over. Sometimes you out-Yomi yourself in situations, and he gets hit with the A, and that will take it.
Yeah, it gave Dave too much time to find his grounder after the YRC. Dave. Staying alive there?
Yeah, staying in there. This whole grand final set so far has been very much in Chetto's favor. Just, it's been really about Breaker Dave trying to fight back and break Chetto's momentum more so than the other way around.
Yeah, and how long you can withstand the Leo pressure, which is very, very strong in this game, the tool set he has now.
Yeah. And Chetto's slowly, as the set's been going on, just adding new options in there, keeping Breaker Dave on his toes. And they've all been hitting too.
Not able to get a wall break, doesn't get a nice throw situation here. Sets up the safe jump, backs up to get it 5-8, but did not find it.
Nice throw. Alright, a little bit of damage. Even if he did continue the combo, it would have been a ton of damage, so that worked out for Chetto, and he gets the wall break anyway. Off a good conversion off JK, you don't see that very often. Nice XP. Gets a little low, that's gonna be dead.
Hey. Yeah. Chetto still having burst, freaking Dave about to get his. Just like that immediate burst. Wow.
2D, yeah, those are working out. 2D is a really good match run in this game. It's only minus 5, you get a big counter off it too if it works out for you.
Yeah, and it sets up that nice back turn OP. Oh. Could have been a big Sepultura, unfortunately could not convert. Does get a nice hit though. We'll be able to get a super off of this.
So there he goes, just go for a safe jump. Yeah, he does. Oh, fake. Alright, why is he stay alive? Goes up for the throw. Another one. Nice block to Breaker Dave.
Oh.
The OTG will take it for him.
So that was interesting there. That YRC actually looked like it gave you the air knockback off that stand stage.
Yeah, because if on stand stage, he's in the air, so it'll knock you back in the air. Yeah. Like in that same sense, you use stand stage to bait throws because you're not grounded for him.
Wow.
Yeah. Alright, it should. No, not quite. Didn't have nothing either. One more touch will do it for him. Yeah, he's trying to force something to happen right now.
Whoa, the S. Right.
That's a good start. And gets a knockdown. Got him again. I would burst while the Breaker Day, but he holds it. Corner ball on his side. Media burns it. Smart stuff. Yes.
Chetto! You know, I was gonna say he didn't use the meter to break the wall before. He held onto it for this post-wall break round, and became very vital there.
Yeah, that's something you can definitely do, is just knock him the opportunity to RC it. We saw that Evo with Otachi with Sonic Fox. He did that, or they did that rather. Just get through the super before you give him a chance to RC.
Yeah, you get that super flash. Unable to hit it. Nice bit on the bird.
TP, no fear.
Yes, he's done with the 5k. Goes for a step dash throw. Gets punished.
Sender there is going to pay for it right now. Oh, drop it too. Well, Claire's slopping it up right now.
Spiral arrow
gets it. Breaker Dave not going down without a fight.
Yeah, this is for Breaker Dave's life here. Run up to the working out for Cheto. Cheto pushing towards the corner. Sonic Boom. Fades out Sepultura. Doesn't go for the punish.
Let's get in there over the boom. So Mix just goes for the meaty 2D. Oh, I missed it. I think I was going for the H boom there. Eight. Nice. Gain the burst. I like it.
No! Hit it, but.
That's crazy. Finds it anyway. Yeah, finds it anyway. He's good. Super. Cheto on tournament point. On this and loser's run back.
And with burst advantage as well. Breaker Dave, though, built a quite a bit back in that.
Alright, first out. Nice throw. Oh, that's big. Hey. Oh, they're showing the maximum respect up there.
Yeah, air down. Well, Breaker Dave will be able to confirm off the super. Has post super knockdown now.
Yeah, I was about to say he's been doing the fake out for the throw this whole time. He'll not give into that time.
And the hard ass will be able to convert here.
Breaker Dave staying alive. Going down to the final game. But when's my fight? Number 32.
Real big brain on that wake up super from Cheto there, post super. You know, pretty well known that post super gives everyone pretty much a safe jump. Aside from a few characters who don't really get too much fun.
Yeah, Gio especially, she gets like safe stuff off of like tons of things too.
Yeah. Yeah. Especially with the close SOTG to the Air Dash JK.
Alright, here we go. Final game of this tournament. Cheto's been hard carrying the momentum so far, but Breaker Dave is doing his best to break it up. Let's see who gets this one. Goldberg.
Instead of range of Spiral Arrow, they're able to punish force the burst out. Oh no! Cheto, breaking.
Yeah, so nice. Crack in this last game. Gets countered from the DP. Luckily, the wall break happened, but still.
Yeah, the right hand. Yeah, unfortunately, Breaker Dave had meter to cancel that throw with.
Alright, that was a good trade for Giovanna. And they're converging? No, too far. But he's in a good spot right now. Throw. Got another one.
I love that option.
Yeah, Cheto being very wary with a super right there. Team Antonio Spark just completely backing off.
Yeah, Breaker Dave should wake up for a lot. Changing it up here, gets tagged by 2K Force, the burst out of Breaker Dave.
Yeah, it was a good burst of Breaker Dave. He will have gone RC and died. Anyone's game right now, one more touch would do it for either of them.
Get Breaker Dave? Well, there it is.
The first. Smart stuff for Breaker Dave. Yeah, that was a crucial moment in the set.
Bob, Cheto get that burst back right there at the end. I'm hoping they're gonna do this.
Yeah, it's hard to resist, but Breaker Dave like that was on the verge of defeat earlier. And my second point, Cheto not going down without a fight though. Gets a super into a wall break. His post super mix-up hands are very strong. This guy right now just beat his way. No, burst babe is on. Breaker Dave's starting to show some cracks. Now both these players. Neither of them have burst.
Yeah,
anyone's game right now.
A lot of nerves here. Both just hoping the other cracks burst. Run up far S. Looks out for Breaker Dave. Pushing towards the corner. Waiting that out the DP.
Here we go. Triple gang going. Gets the overhead. He's giving the full conversion off this. No super though. Oh, drops it prematurely. I like it. The grab with PRC. No problem. We're getting the wall break.
Yeah, this time it's Cheto covering his throw whip there with the PRC.
Another positive bonus, but Breaker Dave might not let him get much out of it. Keep pressing.
The JK doesn't give Cheto much, though. Still in the corner.
All right.
Wow.
Next hit could win for him. Good block from Breaker Dave. Marcy back.
Yep.
And, oh, one more touch. You got to breathe on him. You got to breathe on her, and you'll get it.
These fireballs are threatening the chip damage kill here.
Yeah, Breaker Dave cannot risk it, and the Rekka gets it off the chip damage.
Yeah.
Pegasus is not emptying long enough, and Cheto, with the full loser's run back, wins Wednesday night fights. Good stuff. He played amazingly today.
Yeah, that was a very hard position to be in. It was kind of a war of attrition at that point. Your health is going to run out because your meter will eventually run out and you can no longer FD Leo. And, you know, it was just a bad situation there for Breaker Dave.
It was like a really Pacheco there after that first round where he just got burst baited. But then that's right after that, the next round, Breaker Dave was starting to crack a little bit. And he made a burst point in a worse situation than Cheto did his. So that really, yeah, really broke up the momentum for Breaker Dave there.
Yeah, and Leo's a character you don't want to mess up on because the damage output is so insane from Leo that those situations just cost you so much more. Especially if you don't have meter as Geo, your defense modifier is not that great without that meter buff. So you can bleed like you were a weaker character.
Absolutely. But amazing stuff there from Cheto, dude. He's been entering a lot of these too, and that's his first, I think the first top eight and definitely first win.
Is he Mexico as well?
Yeah, it's Mexico.
So is that Mexico's first win at WNF? I don't think Kusanagi won.
Kusanagi hasn't won. Hexenlancer has won, right?
Actually,
I think Hexenlancer
has won.
Yeah, Mexico comes out. They play in full force here. And we appreciate them coming out.
They're pretty consistent top 80 as well. Usually at least one of them gets through.
Yeah, it's always somebody.
Good news. We did get to $42.30 on the Matcharino. So big thank you to everyone who came out and supported us with that. Really big thank you. Robert, a whole $10. Thank you. Thank you, Star. Another $5 from you. Direct contributions help so much. So I really appreciate it. We've been working at this all day. Hirsch just got done TO and jumped on the mic with me. So big ups to him, the god TO.
Thank you.
But yeah, that's going to be it for us. Check out the Richie Knows app when you can. There is a Street Fighter tournament in there that you can win free $10 Amazon gift card for just participating. But that will be it for me. Check us out tomorrow for Plus R on my channel. I'm Not a Sandwich. With two H's. Another WNF event. And we will be back with Strive next week here as well. So thank you. I will be heading off.
And you can follow me for all your Wednesday Night Fights Guild Gear news. I do tweet it out as much as I can. And just remember, here at Wednesday Night Fights through SoCal and NorCal, we keep Exit on Tuesdays with Pat the Flip, Strive on Wednesdays with us, and then Plus R with, again, on Thursdays with us. So we're keeping all those games alive if you guys want to be playing them.
Mm-hmm. A big trifecta.
Yes.
All right. You guys take care, and have a good night. I'm gonna head up.